Welcome student, welcome to another session of your computer science class. I'm Amitabh Ghosh from Great Mission Public School, Himmatpur Block. So student, as you know, we would be dealing with Pivot Animator, a software which is used for creating animation. So up till now, I told you about what is Pivot Animator, how you install that Pivot Animator on your computer and start working on it. So I already showed you animated clip and few basic definitions of Pivot Animator. I gave you example of stick man, which is also a stick figure. I showed you its movement using segments and those orange and red dots. You might be aware of it. So today I will show you how to create an animated clip using stick figure, or basically using stick man. There's nothing difference between a stick man or a stick figure. Stick man is a figure with a human shape. So I'll show you how to create a basic clip using stick figure. So without any delay, let's start. So student, as I said that we will create an animation today using Pivot Animator. But what I thought is, before creating animation, we have to first understand its control, how you can expand, how you can change stick figure. So we will continue in the next session, but I thought this two topics is important. So inserting stick figure, that I will show you, and before that I'll show you how to edit stick figures. So let's start. Let me minimize this slide. Let me open Pivot Animator from start menu. I clicked on start, scroll down in an alphabetic order. I found Pivot Animator folder. I click on Pivot Animator. Now double click on it to maximize this window. If you remember student, yesterday on left hand side of Pivot Animator, there is a window pane which has different section. As I discussed yesterday, this one is frame, then this one is selected frame, where you have timeline. Then to play that animation, use play, stop and loop control. Then change the background, add different figures. This section is very important, which is a selected figure, where you can control the figure. So this thing we will see it today. Let's say I want to delete this stick figure which is shown over here. So in order to delete, first you have to select the stick figure. So click on it and then click on delete figure, this cross sign. Once you click on it, it's gone. So this frame is blank now. Now you can, you want, you can load a new figure of your choice, or there are some default stick figures available in this software itself. So in order to load stick figure, click on file menu, then click on load figure type. There are default figures which has already been created or comes with this software. So these are the few softwares. So in your book, elephant stick figure is already being mapped. So I click on it. On right hand side, it shows the preview of this stick figure. So once you select, click on open, and that stick figure of an elephant is loaded up. If you watch carefully in this figure, every object or image of this element is made up of only circle and lines. So this element, elephant figure, is also being made using circle and lines. So this is how you can load stick figure by going to
file menu and then load figure type. Now let me go back to the previous option. So here we come back over here where your stick menu is already loaded up. Now I want to show you some more features of figure control, how to increase the size of stick menu. Please select the stick menu. In this section, by default, figure scale is 100. You can increase the size according to your choice or the frame. Do you see this? So it's keep on increasing. So according to the frame setting, you can set your stick figure. Now, if I want to have multiple pictures similar to stickman, then how can I do that? Drag this stickman on left hand side. On left hand side of this figure control, you will find copy figure. So my stick figure is already been selected. So I click on copy, and then I finally select paste figure. Once I click on paste, you won't notice any changes on the frame, but changes has already been meet in an identical form. So drag this stick pen anywhere on the frame and you find the second stick figure has already been created. Now let's say I want to rotate this stick figure with different movement. Yesterday I already showed you how to make changes by controlling this red segments. You can make a movement of the stick figure. But let's say I want to rotate this stick figure. How can I do that if I want to make some changes? Let me show you. On the keyboard, you will find Alt button or alternate button. Press that button and click on any segment of stick figure, and you can rotate in clockwise and anti-clockwise. If you shrink the figure, it reduces in size. If you expand, it will keep on enlarging. So you can rotate in clockwise or you can rotate in anti-clockwise. So let me stop using this now. Let's say I want to increase different parts of this stick figure character. So how, if I drag this segment, it won't make any changes. It is not increasing neither decreasing. It is only moving up and down. If you click on any portion of red dots, it is only making changes in the movement, but it is not expanding at all. So how to expand the size of the stick figure? One option I already showed you by pressing Alt button. This is one option. The second option is you keep on changing from left hand side of the control, it will increase. This is one option. The second option is how to expand the parts of stick figure. Press control button and think which portion you want to increase. Let's say I want to increase the length of vertebrae. So press control button, drag it in the bottom part area. Let's say I want to increase this section around the neck. So keep on pressing, adjust this section also. Now I want to increase the size of leg. But all these things you have to do while holding control button. Hand has become small, so I have to increase this also. Did you see this? If you didn't find comfortable. The figure is not comfortable enough, you can simply delete it by clicking on it and then press this button. It's gone. The color blue now changes to its original color. So that is it for now, how you can make changes in stick figure and how you can load different stick figure images from the default software that you have in this particular application. So in the next section, I will definitely go ahead and show you how to create animation using stick figure. So see you in the next section, student. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.